Good morning, students. Today we'll have to discuss about the reproduction and the second part of the reproduction, that is the sexual mode of reproduction. Sexual mode of reproduction. Because in previous lecture we have discussed the asexual mode of reproduction, where that is the monoparental, that is not biparental, but here the sexual mode of reproduction is biparental. And the first step of the sexual reproduction is the gametization. Means formation of gamete. And that is haploid. It means the two end mother cell divides meiotically to produce haploid gamete. This is the first step of the sexual mode of gametization. The second step of sexual mode of reproduction is the fertilization. It means when two gametes, one is the male gamete, another is the female gamete, so it is called biparental, male gamete and female gamete, to form a 2N zygote. And after this zygote formation, the embryonic development will be. Now, today we will discuss about the how angiospermic plant reproduce sexually. Angiospermic plant. Angiospermic plant means plant having flowers. Then what is flower? Flower, it is a modified suit meant for sexual reproduction. Now, we'll have to discuss about a typical flower. What do you mean by flower? What are the parts of the flower? How many types of flowers? Now, flower. Actually, flower is of two types. One is the bisexual flower, having four holes, and another is the unisexual flower having three holes. Now, a bisexual flower have two types of the holes. One is called essential holes. And another is called accessory holes. Accessory holes means the hole which is not directly involved in the sexual mode of reproduction. Accessory holes, it means the hole of the flower which is not directly involved in the reproduction, but are essential. Here, essential hole means the hole which is directly involved in the reproduction. It means they are involved in the gametization, they are involved in the fertilization, like that. Now we will have to discuss about a typical structure of a typical bisexual flower. But before that, unisexual flower is of two types. One is the staminate flower and another is the pistillate flower. Another is the pistillate flower. Seminate flower means male flower, where calyx, corolla and androecium are three bulbs. In case of the pistillate flower, it is the female flower. Female flower, and the female flower have calyx, corolla and gynoecium. So here you will see that the first, second, third, three bulbs. Here is first, second, third, three bulbs. It means these two are the accessory bulbs and only one essential bulb. But in case of bisexual flower, there are four bulbs. Now we will have to discuss the structure of the bisexual flower. Here we see that the a typical bisexual flower have a receptacle on which the flower is present, having two small calyx and attractive part that is called corolla. It is called corolla. It is called calyx. It is the attractive part which is meant to attract the insect for the pollination of the bees. This is the two bulbs and both are accessory bulbs. Now the essential bulbs are the ovary, this one is the stigma and one is the star. This is the stigma and this one is the star. This one is the ovary, and all three combine to form the androecium, gynoecium. Gynoecium. It is also called pistil. In addition to that, first, second and third bulbs. Now in addition to these three bulbs, one fourth bulb is present. This is the anther and this one is the filament. And both combined form androecium. It means male part. This one is the female part. So in a typical bisexual flower, there are four bulbs. Two are accessory bulbs and these two are the essential bulbs. Calyx and corolla are the accessory bulbs and androecium and gynoecium is the essential bulbs, because these two bulbs are directly involved in the gametization, fertilization and embryonic development. Now we will have to discuss the male part of the flower. In the male part, anther is present. A typical anther has two lobes, both are called anther lobe. Anther lobes, and having attached filamentous structure, that is called, it is called anther and this is called filament. We will discuss in the upper classes that on the basis of the attachment of this filament to the anther, it is of the basic fixed, dorsi fixed, versatile, adenic, etc. Now if you cut the section of this anther, then we will observe that anther lobe have two pollen sac and another anther lobe have also two pollen sacs. There are four pollen sac present in the one typical anther, and in this particular pollen sac the pollen grains are how pollen grains are formed? Suppose this one is the diploid mother cell. It means they are responsible for the formation of the male gamete. Now in the first meiosis, two haploid cells form, but is not complete cell division. So in the second case, in second meiosis, what happens? The two male gametes and two male gametes, it means there are four male gametes are formed from the one male gametes. Four male gametes. And all four male gametes are responsible for the formation of one pollen grain. A typical pollen grain is generally circular, it is not hard and fast, that the all pollen grains are circular. It may be board shaped, it may be elliptical, but most of the pollen grains are circular. This pollen grain has a thin continuous layer. And a thick discontinuous layer. This type of structure is called. It is called exime. Most resistant part of the endosperm. This is called entine. And the part where this exime is not present is called germ pool. It's called germ pool. It has two cell. One is the central, that is called tube cell, and one is that peripheral, that is called generative cell. Generative cell. There is a callous layer, and in addition to that, cytoplasm are present, the vacuoles are present, these are the vacuoles. This is one of the characteristic features of the mature plants. This plant cell, so this one is the characteristic feature, vacuoles are present. This is the one of the typical structure of the pollen. Now in the next video, we will discuss about the how female gamete is formed and what are the process of the formation.